Universal Center for Renovation presents Historical Israelites. This is strictly for educational purposes and commentary of biblical and secular historical literature. So enjoy. Also, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. UNCR, Universal Center for Renovation. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. John 8:32. Emperor Diocletian originated the system of serfdom. What they never told you in history class. Page 276. The famed scholar Bamber Gascoigne, in his book The Christians, provides us with a picture from the corner of St. Mark's in Venice, which has the statue of two 4th century porphyry emperors. Note the nose and lips of these emperors. They have definite African features. Page 276. Black people in ancient Roman history. Wikipedia. Black Romans. The Tetrarchs. Diocletian. Emperor Diocletian was one of the four Tetrarchs. A Roman identity did not suggest a given skin tone. Rather, it referred to an ever-shifting set of cultural traditions, growing more eclectic in later Roman history, to which inherited physical characteristics were of no relevance. The Black, or so-called Black Romans, including Diocletian, were originally from Syria. Judea was called by the Romans Syria, Palestina, Judea, Kingdom of Judah. Wikipedia, Judea. Judea is a mountainous region in the southern part of the modern states of Palestine and Israel. The name is an ancient historic biblical Hebrew, contemporaneous Latin, and modern day term, originating from the Hebrew name Yehuda or Yahawada, a son of the biblical patriarch Jacob, also known as Israel, with Yahawada's or Yehuda's progeny forming the biblical Israelite tribe of Judah, Yehuda or Yahawada, and later the associated kingdom of Judah. In 132 AD, the province of Judea was merged with Galilee into an enlarged province named Syria Palestina. Syria, Palestina, Judea. Provincia, Syria, Palestina, Roman province, Syria, Palestina, also known as Judea. Israelites was also called Syrians. This verse is referring to Jacob, the father of the 12 tribes of Israel. And thou shalt speak and say before the Lord thy God, a Syrian ready to perish was my father. And he went down into Egypt and sojourned there with a few and became there a nation, great, mighty, and populous. Deuteronomy 26 and 5. African presence in early Europe. Ivan van Sertima. Page 211. Unexpected faces in early Asia. Black noblemen, 150 to 200 AD, Syria. Black Syrian noble. Melanocyri means the Black Syrians. Black Syrians. Melanocyri. A New Classical Lexicon. Thomas Swinburne Carr. Page 262. Now, there were in the church that was at Antioch, Syria, certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon, that was called Niger, and Lucius of Cyrene, and Manaen, which have been brought up with Herod the Tetrarch and Saul, Acts 13 and 1. Antioch, Syria, where the disciples of Christ gathered, and where the Jews were first called Christians. Paul's first missionary journey and the first church council at Jerusalem. Chapter 13, verse 1 through chapter 16, verse 5. A. Barnabas and Saul are sent out. Chapter 13, verse 1 through 3. Among the prophets and teachers of the church at Antioch of Syria were Barnabas, Simeon, called the Black Man. Let's skip down to the notes. 13 and 1. Called the Black Man, literally, who was called Nigger. Nigger is a Latin loan word meaning black. Skip down further in the notes. In the light of Simeon's pairing in the list with Lucius from Cyrene, most commentators see this as a nickname, referring at the least to Simeon's ethnic and geographical origin, if not to his race, Niger or Nigger, the Black Man, Simeon's ethnic origin. Wikipedia, Antioch. Antioch on the Orontes was a Hellenistic and later a Christian city. The city's ruin lies on the Orontes River. Antioch was located on the Orontes River in Syria. Ancient city of Antioch, Orontes River in Syria. The city of Antioch, located on the Orontes River. The city of Antioch on the Orontes. The Rights of the Jews of Antioch on the Orontes by A. Kasher. According to Josephus' description, just as the Jews of Alexandria, Egypt, were known as Alexandrians, their co-religionists in Antioch were called Antiochians. For Seleucus, the founder of the Seleucid kingdom, granted them their politeia. He says, furthermore, that they also received honor from the kings of Asia when they, the Jews, served with the Greeks, with them in war. Politeia, Syrian citizenship. The Jews served in the Syrian army. On another occasion, Josephus noted that the Jewish race was scattered all over the inhabited world, mainly in Syria. But it was at Antioch that they specially congregated, partly owing to the greatness of the city, but mainly because the successors of King Antiochus, also known as Epiphanes, had enabled them to live there in security. They even allowed them to participate in the city equally with the Greeks. Now, they were in the church that was at Antioch. Certain prophets and teachers, as Barnabas and Simeon, that was called Niger, and Lucius of Cyrene, and Manaen, which had been brought up with Herod, the Tetrarch, and Saul, Acts 13 and 1. So Jews were first called Christians in Syria. When the war broke out, the Jewish and Roman War in 66 AD, and Greeks and Jews were everywhere engaged in bloody strife, the Antiochians, or the citizens of Antioch, did no harm to their Jewish fellow citizens. When the Jewish-Roman War broke out, the Jews of Syria were not involved. Greeks and Jews in Syria fought, but not Romans and Jews. And at that time, the Greeks were under the empire of the Romans. After the fall of Jerusalem and the subjugation of the Jews, however, bitter hatred arose between the Antiochians and the Jews. When the Romans destroyed Jerusalem, the Greeks living in Antioch wanted to change the civil rights of the Jews living in Antioch, the Greeks sought to abolish their citizenship. The victorious Titus was received by the Antiochians with enthusiasm, but they could not induce him to expel the Jews from their city, nor even to destroy the brazen tablets upon which the franchises of the Jews were inscribed. Emperor Vespasian, Titus, Judean woman.